baby. That's me and you. That had breath, praise the Lord, praise ye the Lord. Amen. I heard a couple of folks around me agreeing this morning, because I'm glad to see you in God's house. come just to be here. He come to help you and to help me. I've been standing here worshiping. I feel like there's a few other folks should be up there. You've had a tough battle. It just gave you a tough week. You made it. You barely made it, but you made it. But the Lord says, I've come to stay. Meet your need. And as you open your heart to me, then I will meet you at that meeting. That's what he wants you to understand. When he's talking about breaking the chains, well, I've never been hit by them, that's a chain of some kind. By the time we don't want to hit it, but we got habits, we got problems, we got shortcomings. All some failures and all this stuff given the example. And we grow accustomed to just keep them sometimes. We say, well, I think I'll just keep them. Maybe we shouldn't worry about it. I've already lived with them. The Lord said, I'll break them. We talk about the glory of the Lord filling the house. That's what we said we come, so the glory of the Lord to fill the house. But when he fills the house, he's talking, as you said about you and me, we're the temple of the Holy Ghost. Amen? So when he comes into the house, this is the house he wants to get into, not this. And this will be here when we're gone. Sit here and we'll go home, but this is the temple. This is the Holy Ghost dwelling place. I'm telling you this morning, God can do more for you in 30 seconds than anybody else can do in your life. But you have to be willing to say, Lord, I got to have some gift. There's others that don't pray. We're going to take time to pray. If I preach, that's fine. I've preached a lot of sermons since I've been here. I got a sermon to preach this morning. But I'm more interested in the peace of the Lord. I'm more interested in seeing you get some help this morning. Because just another sermon, I'm not going to change a lot for you to decide, well, God, I got to have some help. I got to have it right now. Well, the Spirit of the Lord's in the house, I'll just invite you. I mean, it's up to you what you do with it. But in the middle of the week, if it gets worse, what are you going to do? Don't think about it. I'm just trying to get you to think about it. Who we talk about. We talk about there's power in the name of Jesus. We talk about breaking chains. We talk about his glory filling the house. We talk about all these things, but are we just talking? Are we just doing something to be doing something? Are we really going to see this in our house? In us? I do. I thirst for his closeness. I thirst for his power. I thirst and I hunger for his righteousness. I need him. I need him. If you're sick in body this morning, you need prayer, we'll pray for you. When the Spirit of the Lord's in the house, I've learned over the years of ministry, stop and do what the Lord's doing. Thank you. Not about what I'm doing. If you're in the house, you need prayer, come on and let us pray. Let us believe and trust God with you. Let us join together, one mind, one accord, and see God do some awesome stuff. He's God. He's more than enough. He's more than enough. He's more than enough. Hallelujah. Anyone else, you need prayer, come on. I'm not going to wait much longer. You and God can argue that if you want to. That's me, y'all. I'm just telling you what I'm dealing with spirit. All I want to ask you, we're going to pray. We're going to believe God. It's there to pray around these altars and God does some stuff. If they leave, they're going to be better off than coming today, I guarantee. What about you who are in the house? Is everything the way you want it? Is it happy the way your life is? If you are, praise the Lord. If not, you can change it. You can change it through Jesus Christ. A couple of you ladies come around if you want to pray for Sister Tiffany. She's got to go back to the hospital, I believe, this week. Is it? We're going to believe God that everything's going to be 100% well. It's been a tough time. God's bigger than all this. No doubt about it. We'll believe God with us this morning. You're sitting in the congregation. You've got faith that God can heal and extend your right hand this way. Help us out. All we need all faith this morning. We're going to trust God. I want you to pray. Ask God to heal her body. Father, in the name of thank you. right vengeance if I've been doing it. The enemy is out to destroy them, but he knows his time is short. I mean, the Lord can come today. And it'd be okay with you. But it wouldn't be okay with our folks. Oh, they're not ready. They're still trying to decide. They're still working with things, trying to figure out how to get this thing on. But then the last thing the Word of God said, men's love and waxed cold. Not that they don't know that Jesus is Jesus, they know that. They know God loves them. But it's more good than that. It's having to find who we are to get the Word of His. I just feel compelled in my spirit this morning. If you got somebody in your family, when I say family, they don't have to be a husband or a wife or a child. I'm not like your mother, dad, grandmother, grandmother, aunt, uncle, cousin, but be an extra neighbor. But you've been dealing with them and talking to them and trying to encourage them. And it seems like they're having such a battle. And this is what I want you to do. I want you to stand your feet with me. We're going to come to you this morning. We are the church. We are the redeemed of the Lord. We sung about being a mighty army and then beginning to get out of prayers. Get out of what action's going on. Now, I know I've got some in my family, but I know they need God. I mean, they need it desperately. And you know, so many times the problem is when we have known it, we think, well, I know him back years ago, so it's okay, I'm okay. Let me tell you what, I find out certain gods, I never did that. I've got to get closer and closer and closer. If I had to live on what I had last year, I wouldn't be here this morning. I'm not living on what has been. I'm living on what is and what I'm expecting to be. So I want you to muster up all the faith you've got within you. I don't care how many times you talked to them. I don't care how many times they told you to leave them alone. I don't care how many times they've been mad at you. No matter. What matters is today we're going to come to agreement with you. The Word of God said, if any put your ears touching any one thing, I'd ask you to lay on to it, said the Lord. Well, we've got more than the two of us, we've got that number. What's going to happen is I believe Jesus is going to begin to release his spirit. They don't have to be in church for the Lord to get them. They can be riding down the road, Lord, get them. They can be sat by the fishing hole this morning, Lord, get them. They can be on the floor, Lord, get them. You know, they can be off somewhere vacationing, Lord, get them. But like I told you, I thought he ain't wearing my wig, he was there, I got there. So I want you to muster your faith this morning. Say, well, I pray and pray and pray. That's all right. Pray again. Pray without ceasing, the Word says. What I want us to do, if you believe with me, God can do what you're praying for. I want you to set my hand to a day. I want you to begin to declare it now. In the name of Jesus. You call that thing. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for family members. I pray, Father, for those who are confused. I pray for those who are caught up in everyday life, who are doing their own thing, thinking they're doing okay. For those who have put everything in their life ahead of you, I pray for them. The enemy of hell has them bound with chains of doubt and fear and anxiety. He has their mind confused this morning. He has them thinking they can do what they want to do as they want to, and everything's going to be all right. The Lord, I'm reading the Word of God where it says we must give you everything. We must bring all and lay it at your feet. So, Lord, I ask you this morning, God, as we come into agreement in prayer, wherever these family members are, wherever these loved ones are, I pray now begin to send out your ministering spirits to them. North, south, east, and west. Send it out. Send it out. Send it out. And I pray, Father, arrest their hearts right in this very moment. Father God, in 10 minutes or 12, make them look at their watch and say, what is it I feel going on inside me? And God, they will declare for these family members just now, something happened to me at 10 minutes or 12 on Sunday. I felt something I never felt. I had something touch me I never had touched me. I had something change in me. I need you to pray for me like you For the glory of God, for Lord, this is your day. This is your church. This is your service. You've decided to move this way today.
Amen.
That's all that matters, Lord, as long as you do what you want to do. Because it's not about us, but it is all about you today. So I bless you, Lord. I glorify you. I want you to do that as a prayer this morning. If you're willing to give yourself totally to Jesus, not 90%, I'm not talking about 95%, I'm talking about 99%, but 100%, 101%, you'll give yourself to Jesus. God will seal this thing in you. I believe that God out of doubt in my heart. This is what we're going to do today. I'm not going to preach. I don't be the priest. The Holy Ghost will preach. He does so much better job than I do. I'm telling you, to be in the presence of the Lord. You can't buy this anywhere else. And for you to be here, you need to count it a privilege, don't you? He didn't have to let you be here. But you have seen, you have experienced, you see his handiwork. Let me tell you, this is a drop in the bucket compared to what he can do. You can make up your mind this morning, Lord. Before I leave this house, I'm going to give myself over to you. And never again do I intend to be the same. We're going to bless you. So lift up your voices.
Here I stand. Here I
Your
give yourself to him totally, completely. Keep it under the back. Don't argue with God. Don't try to make a deal with him. Just simply say, here I am, Lord. Use me. And you'll be that way. Suddenly things begin to change in your life. But none of us are perfect. We'll never be perfect on this earth. But I tell you, the Word tells me I'm not to be perfect, but I do need to strive to be like Jesus. And when all you say, well, how's that? Read the Word. He tells you how Jesus is. So I want you to leave your thinking. You think about that person you pray for, those folks. All of this afternoon. Just check on them. You may be surprised what the Lord has done for them today. They may tell you, God, so glad you called, and they didn't come. You don't have no one for them. He said, well, they'll get mad at me. That's all right. Because you love them. You did the right thing. Jesus knows how to get through. You just pray and see. Let him give them peace. Amen. So tonight at 6, we're going back to this. See, but God's got the story. You know, I'm at that point in my life, I don't have to have things the way they always have been. If it's singing, if it's praying, if it's preaching, and whatever it is, that's all I want to do. Nothing else matters. So 6 o'clock tonight, come on back and see what it is.